Two police officers are in the hospital this noon. They were injured during a police chase that closed a major road during the busy morning commute. Channel 4 Action News reporter Amber Nicotra is live with the latest from investigators. Amber.
Yeah, right now that suspect is being questioned by Allegheny County Police after leading police on a wild chase that ended with those two officers being hurt. I'm told right now they're at Allegheny General Hospital undergoing a number of tests, but they're extremely lucky after what was a very close call early this morning.
It was really eerie. It was kind of creepy.
That's how Kenneth Godby describes what it was like watching the suspect sit parked at one of the gas pumps for 45 minutes. After failed attempts to get him to move or even talk, Kenneth called police.
I saw the cops pull up, and so I figured everything was all right. And I was washing some dishes in the back room, and I heard two gunshots.
Those gunshots came from police after two Avalon police officers responded and tried to talk with the suspect, only for him to try driving off in his car with one of the officers trapped.
Causing the officers to be in fear for their well-being and their lives, they fired two rounds at the vehicle. Not striking the driver.
The suspect sped up Ohio River Boulevard as police followed behind until officers lost control, crashed their cruiser, landing on this hillside. The suspect kept driving before he also crashed, and police say even that didn't stop him. He tried to run and hid in some weeds, only for police to find him and his semi-automatic handgun. While Allegheny County Police spent hours piecing this together, store clerk Kenneth describes how frightening this was, hearing the gunshots, but not knowing what happened.
I wasn't sure. I figured it could have either been him or the cop that had fired. But of course, I expected the worst.
Now, again, those officers are still in the hospital, but they're in good spirits despite what happened. I'm told one has an arm injury, but I'm told also that the vest they were wearing actually prevented them from getting even more seriously hurt. We're going to get an update from them in about an hour or so to see how they're doing. As for that suspect, again, he is being questioned by police. They're not releasing his name just yet, but we'll have much more on this throughout the day. For now, they're reporting live. Amber Nicotra, Channel 4 Action News.